they're universal in America. Walk into pretty much any building that's open to the public and you'll see them. Roughly 7 by 10 inch plastic signs emblazoned with neon red or green letters that say exit. These things have been around for decades and saved countless lives. But in a world that's increasingly being threatened by complex hazards to safety, like active shooters, some people are questioning whether it's time to move on from traditional exit signs. Welcome to Learn Something New by NFPA Journal. The American exit sign as we know it dates back to the mid-20th century. After the Triangle Waste Company fire in New York City in 1911, NFPA created the Life Safety Code, from which exit sign standardization eventually emerged. In other countries, a wordless sign featuring a little green man has become the standard. While both of these sign designs have undoubtedly saved countless lives over the decades, some experts are starting to question whether we need to take exit signs to the next level. The problem with current signs, they say, is that they're static. What they favor instead is what's called dynamic exit signage, signs that can essentially adapt based on certain conditions or scenarios. If the fire alarm in a building goes off because an active shooter pulled it and is now in the lobby waiting for people to come pouring out of stairwells, it would be ideal to have a building in which the exit signs could change, indicating occupants on upper floors shouldn't exit to the lobby. Proponents of dynamic exit signage also say traditional static signs have simply become hard to find in large, complex environments like airports and malls, where a lot of signage competes for occupants' attention. Having dynamic signs as simple as flashing exit signs would be better, they say. The 2021 edition of NFPA 101 will likely include a new annex section on dynamic exit signage. While it makes note of the reasons behind the growing push for the technology, it also indicates there are some concerns. The proposed language reads as follows. The potential problems of such a solution include the reliability and likely partial level of the information available, the decision-making ability of the individual if human, or algorithm if machine, responsible for changing the sign's message, and the training and habitual behavior of some building occupants who might not detect the change or might choose to ignore the sign's information. Proponents of dynamic exit signage largely disagree with all of those concerns. They say that studies have shown the signs are not only accurate, but people who are placed in an environment with the signs who have never previously seen them are able to quickly learn how to follow them. But until codes like NFPA 101 come to fully embrace dynamic exit signage, they likely won't start popping up in a big way. That said, in a world that's increasingly being defined by smart technology, smart doorbells, smart smoke alarms, smart thermostats, it's probably safe to say that one day, exit signs will get a little smarter too. Thanks for watching. If you like these Learn Something New videos, please let us know in the comments section. Feel free to even pitch your own idea for a topic for a future Learn Something New. Be sure to like this video and share it with your friends, and if you're interested in watching more video content from NFPA, subscribe to our YouTube channel. We'll be back next month with a video that looks at one of the world's most famous tragedies ever, Boston's Coconut Grove Fire of 1942.